Hey everybody, how's it going? My name is Husky, and today I'm going to be doing a tutorial. I'm going to be going over the basics of Photoshop, because Photoshop can be a very intimidating software if you're not familiar with it. But really, when you get past the basics, it's an incredibly useful tool that's fairly easy to use. So I thought I'd make a video going over the basics. So let's get started. So when you open up Photoshop, depending on the version you have, this is the most recent one, you'll be greeted with this screen. Maybe not like this because I have some projects I've been working on, but first thing you're going to do, you're going to go to New File, or you can go to File, New. This is the screen you're going to be greeted with. New Document. For this one, I'm just going to show you guys. If you want to follow along, you can. If you want to just watch, feel free to. So you're going to name it. We'll name it. And for this one, we'll be leaving the width and height as the preset. So 1280 by 720. And the resolution we'll leave at 300. Pixels, if you're unfamiliar with this, are the measurement of resolution. So, you know, they have option for inches, centimeters, even millimeters, but when you get into designing, you're going to want to get familiar with pixels because that interprets the size and quality of what you're working on. And another thing I always like to do is I like to make the background content, I like to do it transparent, and you'll see why in a bit. There's other stuff you normally, you know, can always mess with, but for this just being a basic tutorial, we'll leave it as is. So go ahead and press create. And this is the screen you're greeted with. And this is where a lot of people get turned off by the software because it looks pretty confusing. But, you know, I'm going to make this, you know, this is how I would have wanted to explain to me when I first started. There's really two sections. Well, there's really three, but we'll go over the two first that are very important. The first one is the layers section. That's at the bottom right here. And you'll see we have option for channel 3D. That doesn't matter, just the layers. And always you're going to have, now there's a reason why I made the background transparent, but you're always going to have layer 1 as a transparent background. This will be your background. And so pay attention to the layers. The second one is this toolbar right here. This is all your tools. So you'll have very useful tools such as the magic wand, quick selection, eraser, text, shapes, and obviously you have your move stuff around tool, select multiple things. This all looks confusing, but these tools actually become very useful, every single one of them. If you want more options for a certain one, so let's say I'm hovering over the magic wand, you hold left click it, and it will bring up quick selection, object selection, magic wand. Same with anything else. If you want vertical text instead of horizontal, hold down the left clicker and you'll see vertical type tool. Same with shapes, eraser. If you want background eraser, magic eraser, it doesn't matter. You just hold it down and you get more options. These are the two most, the things you're going to be paying attention to most is the tools and the layers. So let's get started. So like I said, there's one more that I want to go over real quick. And up here, this is pretty familiar for most softwares, is the file. When you click file, you're going to be greeted with a lot of stuff. This is where you're going to create new documents, open old ones, save. But most importantly for me is the place embedded. Now, if you want to get an image that you have saved on your computer on this canvas, you're going to go to file and click place embedded, not place linked, but place embedded. On different versions of Photoshop, it's different things, but on the one I'm on, it's place embedded. So you're going to click that. So I have some pre-saved stuff here I'm going to be using in this. And if you're following along, I'll link those so you can use them too. But the first thing we're going to do is we're going to place a background. So to do that, we're going to, I have this house right here, this house with a nice background. This will be our background of what we're creating. So go ahead and click it, select place. Now here is the image. This will be our background. Now you'll see that it's right here. So that's our first layer that we're placing. It shows up right here, and we're going to drag it out a little bit so it fits the entire canvas. So luckily on the new version of Photoshop, you don't need to do this. On the old ones, you could push shift and it would, as you drag out, it would make it equal. So it wouldn't go all over the place. You hold shift, it'll make it equal. But on the new version, you don't have to do that. You just drag it out. It will stay parallel or symmetric. We're just going to center that. So you're going to drag it out. You can move it around. We're just going to leave it right there. You're going to see that those little lines pop up when it's perfectly centered right there, those pink lines. Once you have it, take your hand off the clicker and press enter. And now our background image is placed, and you'll see it right there. If you really want to get crazy, like with organizing and stuff, you can double click the text right there and name it. So you can name it background. It helps keep things organized. So now what we're going to do is go again to File, Place Embedded. And I have this SUV right here. Again, I'm going to click it, press Place. You're going to see this is our second layer. So there it is. Now, one thing to notice is layers that are at the top are going to be in the front of the canvas. And I'll go more into that when we place some more layers. So we'll go ahead, we'll put this Suburban right here. Right there. Push enter. Again, if you want to be organized, double click. And you'll see what I was talking about right here. So if I click this, click the background, and then I hold down the clicker, the left clicker, and drag it up, car is gone. That's because the background is now in front. So the order really matters when you're working on Photoshop, especially with layers. And you'll see I'm going to place one more thing. So again, we're going to go to File, Place Embedded, and I have this lab right here. So we're going to downsize it a little bit. And, you know, it's a kind of a big lab. Let's just say it's good right there. And again, when you really start using it, this isn't going to matter renaming these, but I'm just doing it for the tutorial. So you see, we have our background. That's towards the bottom because it's the furthest to the back on the canvas. The car is our second layer, the lab is the third. If I were to drag the car up to be towards the top of the layers, you'll see that the lab disappears. That's because it's now behind the car. But if I put the car in the middle, the lab is in the front. That's not a lab, by the way. I'm stupid. That's a golden retriever. My bad, but you get the point. The dog is going to switch locations. So the layer order does really matter. Your background is going to be towards the bottom, and then things that are in the front are going to be towards the top. And that's a really important thing. Now let's say you don't like where the lab is placed, the dog is placed. You have a few options here. You can click it and move it around. You have to make sure you have this tool selected right here. You actually have to click on the lab. So put it right there, but let's say I don't like the size of it. Let's say I want to get crazy. Now we're going to go into edit. It's right next to the file on the top taskbar. I'm going to go edit, and you can go to transform, but frankly, free transform is what you want to click. So it's right here. You're going to click it, and that basically puts us in the exact same thing when we were going to originally place it. You can rotate if you want. If you go to the outer part of the lines, you can rotate it. Go like this, like that. If you go to the corners, you can drag it. And if you hold shift, you can warp it. You can do some pretty crazy things. So, and when you're happy with it, you just push enter. So, say I'm happy with it right there. I'll push enter. And there we go. So, you know, those are the basics, but I talked about tools being pretty basic too. So let's say I don't like this background right here. I don't like it. Say I want to get rid of it. So there's many ways you can do that, but I'm going to show you the easy way. So right here, there's the magic wand tool. Now you can select it if you want and hover over. Oh, make sure you have the right layer selected. That's something else. So if we're working on a certain layer, we need to select that layer. So we're working on the background layer. So we're going to select background. And we're going to again go to that magic wand tool. And we can go and select the background, press delete. I'm messing up here. One more thing. This is the last thing. I keep messing up. You're going to go, once you have that layer selected, you're going to right click it. You can go to rasterize layer. And the reason you do that, it makes it so the layer is edit. You can edit it. And you kind of need to do that if you plan on, you know, erasing anything or getting rid of backgrounds or cutting things out. You do need to do that. So again, for the third time, we're going to go to the magic wand tool, and we can select it and push delete. But the reason I don't really like doing this is because it's precise, but it doesn't get rid of everything. You can mess with this thing called the tolerance, but I don't really like doing that. So instead, what we're going to do is we're going to hold down the magic wand and go to quick selection tool. And with this, you can drag to the parts you want to get rid of. And you'll see why I like that more, because it selected the whole thing. And you can be more precise with it too. So if I press delete, now the background's gone. And to get out of it, this might not be a proper way to do it, but I always, so when you have it selected like that, and you have these things that are on, if you want to get out of that, just click this little square right here, dotted square. Just click it. Then click it goes away. That's just how I do it. And then again, we're going to go to File, Place Embedded, Place. There's our sky, but you'll see it needs to be on the back of the background now. All right. So you'll see we have the sky in the background. So now our layers, they look kind of different. We have the sky all the way in the back. Then we have the house and the trees. Then we have the car, and then the lab. So, there's one thing I don't like about this, though. I don't like the trees. You can see they still have a remnants of the old sky on it. So here's how I deal with that. We're going to go to the eraser. Again, another tool very useful. We're going to click on it. And then right here, under the taskbar, you're going to see this. It's going to be auto at 10 for you. It might be something else, but click down on that. Go to soft round. So I already have it selected, but go to soft round. We're going to up the size a little bit. Okay, so we have that selected. Make sure you have the background selected again. We're just going to get rid of that a little bit. So you get rid of the white. Something like this, it doesn't matter too much. You want to be really precise, you can do some other stuff, but it's okay for what we're doing. So you're just going to slowly get rid of all that. Try not to touch the house. And another big friend of yours is going to be Control Z. When you don't like something, push Control Z. It will go back to what you did before. I don't like the way that looks. All right, for the sake of still doing the tutorial, we'll leave it like that. So that eraser tool is very useful. It's helped me a lot. There's one more thing I'd like to add. This is a basic, so maybe I'll make another video. Let's say you want some text to really complete it. So again, you're going to go to your tool taskbar on the left. Click the text tool. You're going to make a box for it. Doesn't need to be that big, but you can change your color right up here. We'll make it white. You can change your font right up here. I have a lot of fonts to choose from. We'll use this one. Change the size right here. We'll name it Basics. Now again, that layers is very important. Let's say I don't want it in the front. So if I go to edit, free transform, and move it around, let's say I don't want it in the front. Let's say I want it maybe behind the lab, behind the car a little bit. So what I would do, I would grab that layer, make sure it's selected, and drag it down. Or maybe I want it in front of the car, but behind the lab. You see how that works. It's interesting. You know, the further down it is, the further back of the image it will be, or the canvas. One more thing I'll go over during this. Let's say you want to get crazy with the text. You know, you want to do some cool things. You want to maybe add some glow or something. You're going to go to your layers, right here. Double click that text you just put. And now you're going to be greeted with this layer style menu. Again, another very useful tool that this was actually my most used tool by far, because when I first started using Photoshop, I didn't really know what I was doing, and you know, this was an easy way to make things look good. Let's say you want to make it glow a little bit. I'm going to select outer glow. You can click it. Mine is on something stupid, so let me make it white. So you're going to click that little box, make it white. You can go to the size, make it a little brighter. Maybe you want to add some bevel to it. You can do that. Maybe you want a gradient overlay. You can also do that. Make sure you have it, the blend mode selected on normal if you're doing that. They have a lot of stuff for you to choose from, especially on the newer versions. Okay. It's fun to mess with all these. I highly recommend it. You're going to find a lot of cool stuff. I think my favorite for the type of work I do is the glow, outer glow, and inner shadow are the two I use the most. And you can do that with anything. So let's say the car. Double click it, go to the layer. Let's say we want to make the car look different, but not like that. So you click gradient, blend mode. You're going to go down and select color. And you'll see that changes the car's color a little bit. Can make it, we have gradient selected, so it's going to be different colors, but that looks pretty cool. Add some stroke if you want, some inner shadow. Add some glow, add some drop shadow, very useful. We'll even make the lab another color. The golden retriever. We'll make it a different color other than gold. Make it blue. Again, you do that by selecting color overlay, going to blend mode, selecting color, clicking the color box, and choosing it. You can even do that with the sky if you want to. Let's say we don't like the color of the sky. Go to gradient. It's already how we want it. So obviously, this looks like shit, okay? I'm only doing this for the tutorial. That's some of the basic stuff on Photoshop that, you know, I wish I was, because I did learn Photoshop in school, and it was taught in a similar fashion, and it worked. And I tried tackling it before by myself, and it just, didn't work. So I really liked the way they did that, so I tried to kind of mimic the way they taught me. But, you know, those are the basic of basics. You have your toolbar, you have your layers, and then you have on top, you have your file, edit. You know, you have all this stuff that you need to use, and, you know, those are pretty simple things to use. Hopefully this helps you guys. I'll be doing one more thing, show you guys how to save it. So let's go to File. We're going to save the thing we've been working on. So you can always push Control S. We're going to go Save As. It's going to be a Photoshop document, PSD. Go ahead and put a name for that. I'm happy with the name it chose, and save it. Push OK. Now, if you want to export it, that's not going to be an image, the PSD format. That's Photoshop's format if you want to work on it further. But it's not going to save it as an image you can use or upload. So you're going to go to File, Export, and Save for Web. It says Legacy because that's for the older versions of the Photoshop. That's just how I do it. So again, File, Export, Save for Web. You can choose if you want it to be a JPEG, PNG. We're going to do a JPEG. Our quality is bumped up. Everything's as it should be. You're going to choose the file you want to save it in. Press Save. And there you go. Your file should be there. So I hope this helped some of you guys. If you want another tutorial, I'll probably be uploading more. If you want some further insight into the stuff I work on or what I do, I have more tutorials on the channel. But yeah, thank you guys for watching, and have a good one.